I'm super excited to be talking about launching offers. I have put out many different offers over the years, and I've absolutely loved working with students in that way. And I know that, you know, any of you guys have the knowledge, the experience to be able to do that. You may just not know the right way to do it, what kind of offer is best for you, and how to get started. So that's what we're going to talk about today.
Yes. And if you're listening now and you tuned in and you're like, I don't know if this episode is for me. This is for you if you are a music coach already, a music teacher already, or a musician who is thinking about adding additional streams of income and starting to coach or teach. And if you are any one of those things, what I like to call multifaceted music entrepreneurs, or some people say musicpreneurs. but basically, this is going to teach you how to increase your offer suite and streams of income and figure out exactly what offer you should add to your business based on where you're at, what your interests are, how big your audience is, you know, if you are brand new to this versus if you already have an established business that you're looking to grow, this is for you.
Yeah. And again, if you're like, I don't know if this is for me, like if you feel like your income streams have been a little unstable lately, and I would say who hasn't, adding another stream of income that we're going to be talking about today is going to help you so much to be able to feel like, oh, I've got something, I've got several things here that I'm doing to rely on. So if one of them is not going as well, the other ones are going to keep you stabilized and feeling really strong in your business instead of feeling like you're just like moving with the tide of whatever is going on in the world.
Yeah, that's such a good point, because I feel like in 2020, the big word that everyone was saying was pivot, pivot, pivot.
Yeah.
Right? It's like, you have to pivot what you're doing. You have to figure out like what's the best way to make money right now. And we're going to talk about memberships in a second. But what's interesting is I feel like everyone was pushing memberships last year because it was like, it's lower cost. It's easy accessible. That's what people want. And now we're sort of out of the initial shock and the initial need for change in our businesses and also just in our lives. And so what do we do with that? Like, I feel like while there's still definitely the movement to online, which is what we're going to talk about, online offers primarily, there are still a lot of different ways that you can navigate this. And, you know, you don't have to be reactive. You can be proactive to figure out which offer actually makes sense for you and your audience and plan out a launch for that so that it's successful and you're not feeling like you're still in that place where you're like, I'm just trying to like readjust things and get back to some sense of normal after everything that happened last year.
Yeah, I think that's really good to analyze what works best for you, your interests, your personality, where you're at in business, your goals, all of that. Because I know that, like she said, if people are pushing memberships, it might not be the right thing for you. Yep. I know for me, when I first started, like I had a membership and I was like, oh, everybody has courses. I should have a course. And at first I did a course and I was like, no, this isn't for me. Membership is for me, you know, and I had to kind of like just play around with different things and figure out which thing fits me best. And right. That's what's so great about this quiz that we developed is it helps you get a head start on that to kind of analyze the different aspects of where you like to work, how you like to communicate with students, how, you know, what kind of audience you have and all that.
Yeah.
And so then you don't have to spend all this extra time trying things and going, that wasn't for me. I just wasted 3 months, 6 months of my life putting this thing together and it just doesn't feel right.
Yeah. And Bree and I are laughing because it's a pure example of this right between the two of us. Like she has a thriving membership. I started a membership last year because I thought it would be a good offer at the time. And I ended up, I don't know what the right word is, dissolving
it. Sunsetting it. Sunsetting sounds so much better.
Wait, say it again.
Sunsetting.
Oh, yeah, that's a good word. That's a good word. So sunsetting it at the end of 2020 because it just wasn't worth my time or my energy or what I really wanted to do. Or at the end of the day, it wasn't what my clients were desiring. Like I found I was actually better able to sell higher ticket programs, like selling a mastermind program, which was nearly 10 times the price of my membership, was so much easier than trying to sell my membership. So that was just my experience. And obviously Bree's had a different one. And that's what's going to make our conversation even more interesting today, because there really is no one perfect answer for every single person. It's up to your individual circumstance.
Yeah. And it's also like where you're at in your business. For me, a membership was really, really awesome for several years. And I had tried a course and it wasn't the thing for me. But then later down the road, like 5 years into my membership, I had really developed a framework that I wanted to teach to people in a very specific way. And I'm like, okay, now it's time for me to have a course. My first course was like way too all over the place. And all of that information really belonged in a membership. And so I then launched my course like 5 years in, and now my course is doing amazing and I'm loving it because I understood more about, you know, the way I like to run things. And I also, as we'll get into, had really developed a specific framework that I wanted to teach and give people a specific result.
Yeah,